how proud I am of these guys, how hard they worked on this, because you know what? It seemed really easy, but I tried it. It's not really easy. And don't sound near as good what I do. I don't know what's wrong with it. I'm telling you. I'm just not using big clap. But at any rate, I do thank God for each and every one of them. They've done such a good job with that, and they tried so hard, so thank God for them. So this time we're going to bring Sister Jack and the choir up.
Bales is a hard act to follow. We're going to give you the best we got. On behalf of the choir and Sister Jackie, we welcome you. Our cantata, singing, Gloria conveys the message of God's love, His grace and His mercy for each of us. It's the Christmas story in song. We sing of Emmanuel, God with us. It emphasizes His Holy Spirit is always with us. To those walking in darkness, He is light. To those in despair, He brings hope. Christ came to seek and save those which are lost. Just think about it. Our Creator, our Savior, our soon coming King, you can experience His presence right here in this sanctuary today. Open your heart, your soul and your spirit, and find out that He is in the house. We're excited about Christmas. We hope you're excited too, because Christ is the reason for the season. Again, thank you for being here. Merry Christmas, and God's blessings on you and your family. It's Christmas. Ring the bells. Sound the trumpets. Proclaim the glory of Christ, who has come to dwell among His people. This is the season to rejoice, and what better way to celebrate than to sing?
Thank you.
before the hands of the Lord, God's people were already experiencing what it meant to live in expectation. The writings of the prophets were foreshadowing the events to come, even as the world longed for a Redeemer. Centuries of hope and wonder were passed as they waited for God to fulfill His covenant with Israel. But for the people of God, it represents the very foundation of our existence. Hope enables us to live in the confidence that His word is true and He will not forsake His own. And so it was in the fullness of God's time, beneath the stillness of a Bethlehem sky, the hope of the world was born. Scripture tells us they wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn. With a young mother cradling her newborn in her arms. But the scene could hardly have been more different on the Adirondack hillside, where some shepherds stood watch over their sheep. An angel of the Lord appeared in the heavens with the announcement of the ages, that Christ the Lord was born in the city of David. And as amazing as that moment must have been for the shepherds, the nervous shepherds, they had no way of knowing. Church was just getting started. Suddenly, the angel was joined by a multitude of heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace, goodwill toward men."
Thank you.
For unto us a child is born, and to us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Since God sent his only Son, that we may have life, and that we may have it more abundantly. We decorate the tree and add our voices to the carols of old, proudly proclaiming joy to the world, the Lord is coming. To those walking in darkness, he is light. To a people in despair, he is hope. The joy of the season is found in the good news of the gospel. Christ has come to seek and save that which was lost. And life as we knew it will never be the same. son, all because of Amy Tammy. Short of love. which is how the Father can give his only begotten Son, so that whosoever believed in him could live forever. Only love would prevent a king to come as a pauper, to exchange the glory of heaven for the agony of the cross. Only love would look beyond who we have been and what we have done and see something worth redeeming. Yes, love truly is the story of Christmas.
Thank you.
God is good. I won't keep you long this morning, but I want to read a little bit. The Lord bless, I'd like to say a few things to you, and I'll let you go. But if you would, if you turn with me this morning, if you have your Bibles, if not, we'll put the words up here. The Lord's will, I'm going to read out the book of Luke, second chapter. Just where all this just came from, actually. And we're going to start with the second chapter of Luke, and we're going to start out with the seventh verse. It says, and she brought forth her firstborn son, wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the herd, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone around about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. You shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts praising God and saying, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. We've made Christmas something that
don't even resemble the first Christmas. I have my house and you at yours.
We've made Christmas about so many things. The toys, the wrappers, the bows, it's all beautiful. But if you break Christmas down and you take away all the pretty wrappers, the pretty bows, and you take away all that holiday shopping and all the way the stress, you take away all of those things that, the food, the things that we love so much. If you take away all those things, when you come to the end of that, you have something as simple as a baby laying in a manger. But yet, it's complicated. As after this baby, nothing will ever be the same. Nothing will ever be the same. This baby was born that day, praise God. Maybe not a lot of people knew at that time. And he was born in a manger. Laid, praise God, in a manger. Wrapped in swaddling clothes. I could almost look down as they was playing this and I was watching as they looked down upon that baby. I could almost see myself looking down upon Jesus, this baby, laying in this grave. And how they probably didn't have a clue exactly what this baby was going to bring forth. They knew that it was something great because the angels proclaimed it to those shepherds in that field that night. But they didn't have a clue just how great it was going to be. They didn't have a clue when they looked down on that little tiny baby, as beautiful as he was, I'm sure. They didn't have a clue that this baby would change life for every person on the face of the earth. Because this baby was born in the city of David, praise be to God, in this little place called Bethlehem, because this baby was born that night, me and you have an opportunity and a chance, praise God, to get our sins forgiven and to go to a place called heaven. Because of that baby that was born in that manger on that night, praise God, I have a chance to stand before you this morning, not as the man I used to be, but as the man that he made me, washed clean by the precious blood of that little child's blood, washed clean. Christmas, we've made it out to be such a, I don't know what you would call it. Such a big deal. It's so stressful. It's so everything. Christmas is hope, folks. Christmas was started out by this child being born. A promise that God had made to his people. A deliverance of that promise in the form of a baby we would walk into heaven as one of his. I want you to think about that just for a minute. The Bible says there's none good, no, not one. I think that includes everybody. No, not one. Jesus Christ died for everyone, whether they was good, bad, or in between. He was born that night to die on a cross. He was born, he came to give his life and to shed his blood for me and you. What a difference this baby made in the lives of those that know him as their Lord and Savior. What a difference he made in the life of the pastor that's standing before you this morning. I don't stand here perfect. I'd like to tell you I am. But my wife and anyone else that ever knew me would say, no, he's not perfect. But I stand here this morning, a child of the Most High King. I stand here this morning, a child of this baby that was born in that manger that night. Because, praise God, of what he done. Because he came that day, I can stand here and tell you that one sweet day, when I close my eyes for the last time over here, I'll open them over there and praise be to God in the splendors of glory with my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Because this baby was born that day, praise be to God, there's been drug addicts that's been redeemed. There's been people, praise God, of all sins, of all things that they've ever done that's been forgiven. Because this baby was born, heaven, praise God, will have people that will reside in it one sweet day.
Amen.
Because this baby was born. And we can make Christmas whatever we want to make it. I want to pull it back to the beginnings. I want to pull it back and forget about the presents and forget about the wrappings and forget about all the things that we've made it up to be over the years. And I want to pull it back to this baby that came because God so loved each and every one of you. That he gave his only begotten son. Seeing him be born in a wrapped in scarlet clothes. The world had no place for him at that time. Not even in the inn that they went to. The world still doesn't have a place for him. Still doesn't have a place for him. Over 2,000 years later. But for those of us that know him as Lord and Savior, praise be to God. I got a place for him this morning. I got a place for him. He resides within me, and I reside in him this morning. And one day, folks, one day, I'm going to close my eyes for the last time over here, and I'm going to go to heaven because this way. We can make Christmas to be whatever we want it to be. But what it was intended to be was a kept promise from God Almighty. A Savior was born that day. A Savior that could save the world. If only you would come. If only you would bow before him. Give your life to him. Savior. There's been a lot of great people born in our world in this time. But there's never been anyone born like Jesus. Why we celebrate Christmas should be because of what God gave us. He gave us a promise. He gave us a plan. With all the love that was within him and his only begotten Son. We go at Christmas and we buy so much and we put it under our trees because we love our kids. We love them. We want to do so much for them, just as much as we possibly can. God loved you so much that even though you wouldn't serve him, even though you didn't want to serve him, he loved you so much that he gave his son the best gift that was ever given. Came as a baby in a manger. This morning, I want you to remember that Jesus Christ truly is the reason for this season. It has nothing to do with anything else. It's just him. It's what he gave to us. It's what he brought by being willing. An everlasting promise for those that know him as Lord. How much better could it be? That's what Christmas means to me, folks. And if you know Jesus as your Savior this morning, I hope that's what it means to you. Because if not, then we need to get back to the basics. We need to pull away all the craziness that the world's added into Christmas. All the craziness that we've made it. And we need to get down to that baby and that manger again. And then we need to realize Christmas is far more than a fancy package below a tree. It's far more than what's the best gift I can buy you. It's all about Him. I love you, but I can't love you like Jesus loves you. I can't do for you what Jesus can do for you this morning. I want you to think how many troubled souls that Jesus has helped. How many souls has been bound for a hill that Jesus has set free. And still today, over 2,000 years later, this same Jesus is still setting me out of here. Amen? He's still the promise that he came to me. He's still the truth in a world that don't know truth anymore. He's still this morning, my alma mater. I hope he's yours. I pray from the bottom of my heart that you have a blessed Christmas. But I pray that if you don't know Jesus as your Savior, that you come to know him before it's everlasting. Time will come and go, folks. You blink, and the young will become old. It goes like that. Time will come and go. But this baby that was born, it's the same yesterday, today, and tomorrow. He never changes. That love never changes. That promise never changes. That's what makes Christmas special to me. I love you this morning. I thank God for you. I want you to know something this morning. If Jesus speaks to you, if he's ever spoke to your heart, you don't have to be in the church to be saved. You do have to have an invitation from Jesus to be one of these. If he spoke to your heart this morning, please make this the best Christmas you've ever had. Come, give your life to him this morning. Now, I don't normally do this, but I'm going to. I wonder if somebody here, you know, somebody, can somebody get us a song?